future music producers, welcome to this video. I will show you here how to put effects in your clips and the most important ones in Live 9. If you're looking for something in detail, check the index in the video description to be quick. Audio effects in general are added once your basic track is complete and you want to add some extra feeling to the sound. Go to the browser on the right. Inside the instruments section, you find sample clip generators that you use to create sound. Then you have audio and MIDI effects, which are quite different. An audio effect wants a sample input and gives a sample output with sound. So this means that you can apply any audio effect on all sample clips, samples generated by instruments, or MIDI files that do have an instrument. The MIDI ones are the same, but they work with input and output as MIDI. So you can apply them just on MIDI files, and you can listen to their effect just after adding an audio instrument to the MIDI file itself. Let's suppose to have imported a sample file. At the bottom you can read to drop audio effects of such space, if it's not shown the waveform. Just add the effect you want there. This will compose the first part of a sidechain. After this effect, you can add more and more effects, one following another. Be careful, because sometimes the effects order does change the overall effect given. Each effect window will have the on-off button beside its name. This is important to hear the difference between putting the effect or not. You will have many options in each window for this. Just remember the dry wet knob, that it is always present. An high dry percentage means hearing the original sound of the sample than the one with the effect applied. And wet means just the opposite, making the effect louder. There are effects for MIDI clips too. Just add a simple MIDI clip with an instrument inside. Here you can add both audio and MIDI effects, but in a precise order in the sidechain. Firstly, you add the MIDI effects, then the signal is still in MIDI without sound. Then you put the conversion of the MIDI file into a sample file, made importing an instrument or a device generator. And just after this you can add audio effects, where you actually have sound, and going on with such a chain. Turn them on and off to hear the differences. Just do not turn off what gives the sound output to your MIDI track, or you won't hear anything anymore. These effects have properties that can be changed in time. This is called automation, and it's managed differently between the session view and the arrangement view. While in session view, go in your sidechain build and choose which effect property to change in time. Then just right-click on such property and go to Show Automation. The software will select such property in the slot below Envelope section. At this point, you can change the value of such property selected through the envelope line on the right, or using directly the draw mode. Hear how the property changes in time according to such envelope line drawn. If you have problems about how to use envelope, check the video related into this show. Remember that any property that has an envelope line personalized will be marked through a small red square right close to it. What about the arrangement view? Go to a property to change in time, right-click on it and go again to show automation. Differently from the session view, the envelope line is shown right on the track in the arrangement view. So you can use again draw mode and edit it the same. On the right you have two slots below the name of the track. The first one selects the effect to change in time, and the second one its specific property. Between the effects shown in the first slot, you will find also mixer, which is not an effect added, but includes inside the main properties of the track, such as volume or panning. Once done with the envelope line, play the clip. You will see the knob changing in time according to the values inserted. Notice that the envelope line in the arrangement view and in the session view are different. If you go back to the session view, you will find again the same line put in there firstly. In case any session clip is recorded into the arrangement view, the envelope line in the session view is recorded as well, and so in the track in the arrangement view, you will find the envelope line that reflects what recorded. Now, let's see quickly some very important audio effects. I'm going to show you the filters. Go to the audio effects section and then drag the effect called auto filter. This will make you add a filter. Then drag also the spectrum and make sure it is put right after the auto filter. In each effect window, you can change properties by moving knobs, changing numbers by dragging them, or simply working through the graph shown, where the yellow point represents where you are moving. Have a better look at the spectrum by clicking on the little dark arrow in the left top corner, making it more enlarged. This graph shows you the frequency spectrum of the audio output signal related to the clip that you are working on. The orange line states the intensity of each frequency in decibels or dB that you can see on the left in a logarithmic scale, so that a plus 1 decibel means increasing by 10 times and minus 1 means dividing by 10 times the intensity. You can eventually change the graph manually on its range or set the linear scale instead of the logarithmic one. Just edit all through the spectrum window. Now you can see the effect of the filter. It is something that cuts a range of frequencies instead of others. So a low pass removes the high frequencies of the spectrum. An high pass filter cuts the low frequencies and a band pass one cuts the highest and the lowest frequencies. There are also many options inside that you can try out. In case you put filter and you put the spectrum right before the auto filter, the spectrum won't see the effect applied. It will show right the signal before such filter on. Similar to the auto filter is the IQ8, where IQ means equalizer. With the help of the spectrum, you can set a very precise filter, where you can put and set up to 8 control points. Decide for each point the frequency and the gain at that point. In this way, you are right equalizing the sound, putting the frequencies you want more intense or less. Let's now see the distortion effect. This effect changes the waveform of the signal, making it completely different or even more harsh. This can be made by effects saturator and vinyl distortion. Just try them out. In particular, saturator wants you to define a wave. The central straight line means the plain original sound, while the flat sides are the maximum values that the signal can have, maximum and minimum. Any change to this graph, adding some droop, ripple and oscillation, will distort the signal. Turn the effect on and off to hear how the signal was and how it is like after. There are then the flange and the chorus effects. A flange effect is a phase shift with the channel itself, creating a special feeling towards your ears. This is made by the flanger. Move the circle and the frequency to hear it. A chorus effect instead makes a solo channel sound, a chorus of more channels that are identical to the one considered, and it's made by the chorus. This kind of effect seems to have a sound more expanded in rooms. You can have a similar effect through the autopan, which plays with the stereo channels. A very important effect is the reverb one. This adds a metallic echo to your clip being played that makes it like more expanded. We can do this through the reverb. You have many options here, just try them out. The reverb effect affects especially the channels with a sick sound, like a kick or a snare. There are also the resonators and the corpus that can be used very well for a good reverb effect with a precise note set or even instrument. The traditional echo effect is usually called the delay effect. An echo effect is simply a delay that has a small distance in time with the original sound and is usually composed by low frequencies. The general delay effect can be applied in many ways in live, and each delay is particular. Choose the simple delay to make a delay without any particular effect. Otherwise, you can choose between filter, drain, and ping-pong delays, and also the beat repeat. The delay can be put not just on the original sound on its own, but between its two stereo channels. The simple delay can do this. The phasing effect is a little more different, done by the phaser. This puts together the two channels with a different phasing time, so that you will hear a deep sweep effect. Have a look also at erosion and redux that can add noise to your sound. As a last step, I will show you what to use to give a great quality to your sound. It's very important in audio production to have the right frequencies at the right intensity, not to have too many high peaks or spikes that can disturb ears and so on. Add in your sidechain delimiter. Edit the ceiling to attenuate the peaks with the dBs you set. The ceiling is simply the maximum dB reachable by the sound. Help yourself with the spectrum. Add with a limiter the compressor. To better understand this, click on the third icon at the bottom. The compressor will show you a continuous graph in real time, representing the signal's peaks in soft gray color. The compressor limits these peaks in the best way you like. The yellow line on top states the effect of the compressor, the orange one the threshold set. Peaks that overcome such line are weakened and limited. Use ratio to change the strength of the compression, whereas attack and release set how much fast or slow the compressor must act in time, while attacking the peak and right after it. For example, a shorter time attack means that the compressor takes less time to attack a peak too much high, whereas a very slow release makes the compressor release the intensity of the sound just after some time the peak weakened. The yellow line is the gain reduction line. When it is flat, the compressor is not acting, so the sound output stays the same. When such line starts to go down, the compressor is acting, as much as such line goes down. Click on expand to make just the opposite effect, such as expanding the sound that goes over the threshold. Just try it out. A new feature of Live 9 is the glue compressor. The end in orange color is the intensity of the compression active. Set the threshold knob and the range one, which decides the maximum compression to apply to the signal. Well, these are the most important audio effects to keep in mind. You do have also the MIDI effects, just try them out. If you are interested in creating your first beat, just check the video in this series of tutorials. Thanks for watching.